Hi guys, it's me. I'm coming at you with an update on Peyton. It's been a little bit. I should have done an update after his doctor's appointment, but things were so crazy. And things have been so crazy. He went to the pediatrician on the 21st, which was the day after his birthday. Of course, his birthday was the 20th. He got 4 shots, 2 in each leg, 1 for meningitis, and the other 3 were for, I don't know what they were for, the Prevnar, I don't know. And then he had a finger prick to check his iron, and I'll get onto that a little bit later. What? He weighs 17 pounds, and he is 28 inches long. He hasn't grown any at all. Not really, no. He's still little. He wears a size 2 to a 3 size shoe. He's in 3 to 6 months to 6 to 9 months, depending on, you know, the brand, the clothing. His ears are fine. He has no problems with his ears. We're always worried about having tubes put in his ears. We were. But his ears were fine, so we don't have to have tubes put in. Although he screams when you hear, like, whistle, like with a whistle in your mouth, or, you blow on a blade of grass and it whistles, he starts screaming. He doesn't like it at all. But besides that, he did have 7 teeth, the three on top and the 4 on bottom, but he's got his 1 year's in on top and his 1 year's on the bottom. And the ones next to the 1 year's next to the 4 that are on bottom. I don't know what they are. Probably his eye teeth, I'm not for sure. I don't know if the eye teeth are just on top or on the bottom. But he's got those in, so he's got a total of like 13 teeth. Hey, Bubba. He has been a crazy little boy. He's constantly walking. He doesn't crawl anymore. Only when he's lazy, but he rarely does it. He loves playing outside in the grass. He loves going barefoot outside. He laughs all the time. He says some little things, like he says ouch, and he still says daddy, and he says mama. He says get. He says, like, you tell the dog to get, he goes get. He says Ed, my stepdad, his name is Ed. We call him still grandpa, but he hears other people calling him Ed. So he says Ed, 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 Ed. He says, you know, just little things like that. Did I say he says ouch? Like if he falls, he goes ouch, ouch, ouch. It's so cute. And then, he won't say any right now, but it's just, you know, when you don't really notice it. Or when he's doing something and he does something and he'll fall or say it or whatever. Rory! No. Doug's barking, whining. He says hi sometimes too. He go hi, hi. But he drinks 2 bottles a day, 8 ounces, and we have 3 ounces of that is goat's milk, so that's good. Speaking of goat's milk, I talked to the pediatrician, and we decided to start feeding him goat's milk to get him fully on goat's milk and off of formula. So every couple days I keep adding more goat's milk. So this is 3 weeks ago. I added, started at 1 ounce, went to 2, then I went to 3. So here shortly, the end of this week, I'll probably go up to 4 ounces. And we'll just keep doing it until he's off of formula, period. So we've only been buying like 1 can of formula at a time. But back to the finger prick to check his iron. Rory! The pediatrician told me that his hemoglobin was low after that finger prick, and he doesn't clot at all. Like, his blood is really thin. He just bleeds and bleeds. He needs to put gauze on and just try to keep it under control. Anyways, his hemoglobin was low, so they sent me to the hospital to go get blood drawn. So he had the 4 pricks in the legs, and then they had the finger prick, so that's, you know, 5. And then they had just dry and draw blood out of both elbows. So they did one inch side, and they couldn't get any blood. They fished around for the vein, couldn't get it. It made me so angry. I was in tears. It was really bothering me because he was screaming. And they told me to come back the next day. So I went back the next day, and they got blood out of his arm again, finally. And I got back to me with the results probably a week later, and they told me that he's anemic. So they put him on an iron supplement, so the little drops, you know, twice a day, morning and afternoon. And then the pediatrician also told me to give him a can of Pedi once a day to help him gain weight. But he doesn't like it, so I haven't been giving it to him. I'm going to try again, but he just won't drink it. He's so crazy. But, so we were getting, we were buying goat's milk at the grocery store in New York, the state up. And they were, like, the little cans of, like, evaporated milk cans, which aren't very big. They're like that, well, I don't know if this is going to be, you know, roughly sized, but. It was 6 cans for $26, and they're like evaporated milk cans, like the small ones that you would put in like a pumpkin pie. And they're goat's milk. And so it was kind of expensive, so I ran out, so I decided to go to one of the Amish farms around here and get some goat's milk. Now, it's not pasteurized, so this led me to researching how to pasteurize goat's milk, because goat's milk is easier to digest than cow's milk, and it doesn't have the protein. So Peyton can digest it. So we've been doing this, and just today I started going to the Amish and learning how to pasteurize goat's milk. So you have to double boil it, like get one pan, put a couple inches of water in it, and then put the goat's milk into another pan and put that into the other pan of water and boil it at 165 degrees for 30 seconds. So that's what I did today, and it's actually not that hard. So you boil it to 165, and then you have to let it cool down to 40 degrees, and then you put it in the jars or whatever. So, yeah, and then tomorrow I go back and I get another gallon. So I've got like a gallon and maybe, I don't know, one of the little chug milks containers of goat's milk to give to Peyton, and he seems to be doing okay with it. He only goes with 2 bottles a day. I think I said that. He's mostly on food. Big people food. And I don't know. He's been doing really good with it. So he, basically that. I go back this month to check Peyton's weight and his ears again. Hopefully everything's still okay. And then Rory! She keeps going in my room. So yeah. I think that that is everything. I've pretty much talked your ears off. The weather has been so nice here. It's been like 81 degrees and it's, you know, May. It's so nice. Not nice enough to go swimming. Rory! Oh, the dog. But he loves to be barefoot. He loves to go outside and walk around barefoot. He loves outside. He has a sandbox, so he's in the sandbox a lot. Rory! Knock it off. We have a gate up in the kitchen so she can't get through. She doesn't like it. But he just loves being outside. Say hi, Bubba. But yeah, so little man, he's crazy, he really is. But anyways, I am going to let you guys go because my dog is being annoying and I've run out of things to say. So all right, I will talk to you guys later. Bye.